the doctors, the panel of doctors which had done the post-mortem, has narrated in detail the nature of injuries on his body and on his person. And that makes it absolutely clear, because there are abrasions, there are contusions, which actually, make it absolutely clear that he was tortured, he was manhandled, he was assaulted before he finally died. So it couldn't be a natural death. The UP police had floated the theory that he ventured out early in the morning from the guest house that he was staying in. He ventured out for a morning walk and he fell down because of some kind of an asphyxiation that happened to him suddenly. He ran out of oxygen. The oxygen supply to his brain was suddenly cut, and therefore he fell down, collapsed, and passed out. So that definitely is a major point of contention. If you look at the kind of allegations that have been leveled by the family of IS officer Anurag Tiwari, because clearly, nobody who dies a natural death could sustain such kind of grievous injuries. And that is absolutely clear from the kind of details that the doctors conducting postmortem have actually noted in the postmortem report. Okay. The nature of injuries, the kind